Hey guys, welcome back. This is my pregnancy update for weeks 25 and 26 of my pregnancy. And I'm going to link all of my other pregnancy videos in the series down below so you guys can check them out if you haven't been following along. When you're watching this, I am 27 weeks, about to enter my third trimester. Pretty exciting. I am feeling a bit better as far as many of my old symptoms go. But let's go ahead and start with baby stats. So this week, the baby is probably about 14 inches long, which is pretty cool. I love the Ovia app because the app shows you, you can pick a different theme instead of fruits and vegetables for what size the baby is. They'll let you choose like little critters, Parisian bakery, like weird stuff. But I chose a fun and games one this week and it was a bowling pin. So baby girl inside of me is a bowling pin. She's about 2 pounds, could be, you know, 15 inches, 3 pounds, 1.5 pounds and like 13 inches, something like that. But I don't have another appointment. I haven't had an appointment since I filmed my last pregnancy update. So I don't have anything to report from the doctors. But if you remember in my last update, I did say that they had measured my fundal measurement, where they take the tape measure and measure the top of your uterus to the bottom and see how that goes. I was measuring 3 weeks ahead and they said like at the next appointment we were going to measure that again, maybe do a growth scan to determine, you know, how the baby's growing in there, if she's like really big. And then also to find out if I had gestational diabetes, because that's a common symptom. Could just be that I have a big baby or a big uterus, but that's one thing that does stand out when you have diabetes is your large measurement there. So I've been kind of trying to watch what I eat as far as sugar goes, monitoring my sugar content. And one thing I did notice was when I eat my sugary cereal in the morning, I throw up. I had 4 Girl Scout cookies one afternoon, I threw up. So I'm like, maybe there's something to the sugar thing. So I have a friend who, sorry if I sound stuffy or anything like that, I am recovering from a cold. If you guys remember in my last update, I said, I think I'm coming down with a cold. Well, here I am 2 weeks later, still fighting it off. I can finally breathe through my nose though, but I do occasionally have some phlegm and I might clear my throat in the video, but sorry about that. Anyway, I have a friend who does have gestational diabetes and she checks her own blood sugar. So I had her check mine twice this last week. Once it had been about 2 hours since I had last eaten and my sugar was 109, which is still well within the good range. I think it had to be under 140 or 150 if you had eaten in the last 2 hours or something like that. And then I had her take it 2 days later when I hadn't eaten in about 4 hours. And it was 80. So my sugar was really low at 80. So I'm not sure about the gestational diabetes thing. Maybe my fasting blood sugar is fine, but then I don't handle high amounts of sugar when I eat them very well. Maybe my body doesn't process it. We'll find out at our next appointment. And our next appointment was going to be the like 28-week gestational diabetes or glucose test where they have you drink the drink and draw your blood and see how you handle the high sugary drink. Anyway, so I was like, well, that's okay, cool. We'll find out soon enough anyway. But I didn't want to be sick either, so I've been trying not to eat a lot of sugar. And then the other thing they're going to do at that appointment is measure that measurement again. If it still comes up 2 or 3 weeks ahead, then we will go ahead and do a growth scan. Initially, we had scheduled the growth scan, basically an ultrasound, to measure all the things of the baby to make sure she's not like giant or something. But I canceled that part of the appointment because it was like, we don't even know if there's anything wrong, and that's like $100 or $200, you know, to find out that everything's fine. And when we're going to do the glucose test anyway, and they're going to measure me. If those two come up, you know, bad, then of course I'm going to do another ultrasound. But we figured we'd rather have one more ultrasound if we're going to do one closer to the end so we can tell how big she's going to be at birth and what position she's in and stuff like that. That would be our time to choose for an elective ultrasound rather than now when everything could very well be fine. I could have just had a full bladder that day, you know, when they did the measurement. So might be nothing to worry about. As far as her movements, I have been feeling my baby move like so much more. So I started feeling her in weeks 19, 20. I could feel like little bubbles or something going on in there, but I wasn't sure what was going on. It was almost like I had to say, was that the baby? I wasn't sure. Like never sure. Well, now, I mean, since week like 24, 25, definitely in week 26, I mean, I could tell like she was like punching me from the inside. I was like, not painful, but I could definitely tell. Well, then I kept having my husband like, come here, put your hand here on my belly. And he'd do it and he never felt anything. Well, one day I had him do it and he was at the right place at the right time. And she just like really kicked him hard. And he was like, oh, I felt it. You know, it's really cool watching him go through it with me because I've been feeling it for what, 7 weeks now. And he finally got to feel the baby move. And I think it became more real for him, you know. And then I have been able to see the baby move like just from the outside, just looking down at my bare stomach, I can see my stomach moving. I'm like, whoa, that's weird. So I wondered, you know, can my husband find it? So finally one day I had him just stare at my stomach when she was being really active. And I'm sure he thought I was very weird, but he was like, oh my gosh, I just saw it move. I'm like, I know, she's been doing this. So when I take my baths at night, I always like look at my stomach and I can tell because the only thing that won't submerge in the bathtub now, I mean, maybe my knees, if I have my knees bent, they're too high over the water, but is my belly. My belly like sticks out over the water. I can't submerge it because if I have my belly submerged, then the water's too full, right? And it starts draining itself anyway. So anyway, my belly sticks out. So when I'm in the bathtub, I'm just like watching a show. She's putting on a little show for me and I just see her like, brr. So that's been something pretty cool this last couple of weeks. I have definitely been enjoying watching her move, feeling her move, and I'm definitely still experiencing those hormonal cries, but this time, this last 2 weeks was a good thing. Like last night, I was sitting on the couch, laying down, and I lifted up my shirt and I was just watching her move and feeling her kicks, and I was feeling really good, you know? And I just started crying, and my husband's like, what? And I'm like, it's so cool to be pregnant. Oh my God. And I just, you know, I just went on about how amazing it is and how, you know, I can't wait to meet her and how excited I am and how it's finally happening and I feel amazing. And he was like, oh, I'm so glad to hear you say that because all I've been doing is puking and, you know, feeling these horrible symptoms and complaining and whining and crying because I'm sad or crying because whatever. And he's like, I'm really happy to hear that you enjoy being pregnant now. And I'm like, I mean, I won't know if I say enjoy, but you know, it's still, it's pretty cool. That's one of the perks. I did order some more clothes. I'm actually going to be doing a haul and try on for you guys. But when I was showing my husband the day the box arrived and I was trying on all my clothes that I bought their maternity, and I was like, you know what's really cool about being pregnant? I've spent my whole life feeling fat, right? Like feeling like I need to lose weight or whatever. This is the first time in my life where I don't care. Like, I love my belly. Like, I mean, yeah, my boobs are bigger, my belly's bigger. I'm sure I'm bigger elsewhere. I've gained probably 15 or 20 pounds, but you know, I just don't care. When I get dressed in the morning, I'm not thinking, does this outfit make me look fat? Are people gonna think I look fat in this? I'm not thinking that anymore. It's amazing. I'm finally thinking like, does this make my bump look cute? Or like, is this shirt long enough to cover my bump? That's what I'm thinking when I'm getting dressed in the morning. And it's been really fun to experience that change because for the first time in my life, like, I'm gaining weight and nobody's telling me I can't. Dang it, you know, I'm gonna do it. And it's just a healthy rate. The doctors aren't concerned or anything. So I feel good. I was just telling my dad that I went to my neurologist appointment a few weeks ago. I'm pretty sure I updated you guys on that, where I was getting headaches very frequently. And the neurologist told me to take magnesium every single day and that you won't notice right away, but over time, having magnesium in your system will help, you know, decrease the frequency and the severity of your headaches. And I'm like, okay. So I've been taking magnesium every day for like 3 weeks now, and I hadn't had a single headache. So I told my dad that, and he gets headaches a lot. I was like, man, you should take magnesium because it's really good and it's been helping me and I haven't had a single headache. What happens? The next day I come down with a headache and it has been there ever since. And I'm like, okay, so maybe it wasn't the magnesium. Maybe I just had a good streak of my pregnancy. But as far as what I've been craving, I definitely crave different things now. I haven't been to like the fast food Mexican place and gotten my bean burrito in a little bit. I'm craving more like, I have had salads a few times. Olive Garden salad dressing has been hitting the spot for me, which is amazing, guys, because I seriously went like 3 or 4 months without eating any vegetables. So it's like really good. I'm still craving sweets, but I'm trying to curb that. I've been eating oatmeal more often because that's known to help with acid reflux. It's just one of those natural foods. Bananas and lower sugar oatmeal. I'll be getting like the Quaker instant packets of lower sugar, and they have like strawberries and cream, peaches and cream, maple and brown sugar, apple, cinnamon, you know, cinnamon, whatever. So I've been like varying which one I have every day. So that's been helping. I still have a very high like sensitivity. My nose is so sensitive, guys. Like a dirty dish in the sink, I'm like, I can smell it from across the room. I'm like, oh my God, what is that? Did you take out the trash? Oh my gosh, whoa. My husband goes in there and he's like, oh yeah, there was one dirty dish. And I'm like, okay, well I can smell it. So I gag, you know, but it's nowhere near as bad as it was in the first trimester. Man, that was awful. That was like, I couldn't open my own refrigerator without dry heaving. So very excited that it seems to be subsiding a bit, but I would let you know it is still there and my senses are definitely heightened. As far as anything else, I have experienced some discomfort wearing my shoes, and here I'm about to enter my third trimester, so I guess it makes sense. I'm still able to wear my wedding rings and I can still wear all of my shoes, but like by the end of the day, they're leaving marks in my feet where those shoes never used to before. So I know that I'm experiencing some swelling, and that's perfectly normal at this stage in pregnancy. I'm just hoping that my wedding ring hangs on a little bit longer. You know, I would really like to make it till May with being able to wear my shoes and my rings, but I have a gift card for a shoe store, so I've been holding on to that since my birthday in January because I knew my feet might grow and I might want to buy some new shoes. So it's coming. I have a feeling in the next month or so I'm going to be buying some new shoes. Just some flats. The high heels are just not really my friend anymore, and it's not that I can't wear them. I haven't experienced any balance problems, but definitely not feeling as comfortable as I used to. And I don't want people's like comments like, oh, should you be wearing those shoes? You're pregnant. You know, I just don't want to hear it. Nobody has said anything like that, but I don't want to be 9 months pregnant in like 6-inch heels and have somebody make a comment. So that's okay. I tend to wear flats when I'm not at work anyway, so I just lowered my heels. Now I'm wearing like my 1 or 2 inch high heels instead of like my 3 or 4. No big deal. So another big update is the nursery. We have finally gotten it painted. My mother-in-law was here this week when I was at work, and she painted the nursery because I didn't want me around. They didn't want me around the fumes and everything. So that was really nice. My husband and mother-in-law worked on the nursery. We have the walls painted, the baseboards, the closet doors, everything went back in. I bought storage bins for the closet. I decorate, you know, I organized and sorted all of her clothes by size. I have not bought anything for the baby as far as clothes go, and she has a whole dresser full and then like 7 bins full of clothes in her closet. Like, what? But I also bought some storage bins, like cubbies, for underneath the changing table on the 2 shelves below it. And my mother-in-law has sanded that. It was a dark wood, and she sanded it and painted it white. We haven't quite gotten it back into the nursery yet, but it was drying last I checked. But pretty excited to have the nursery kind of put together and more organized. I'm feeling the nesting urge big time. Like, I want to give up sleep and just go and play in the baby's room and like play with her clothes. I'm like, what? I want to give up sleep? That's weird. But speaking of sleep, I have been sleeping okay. We do have like all of our plumbing fixed now, and the bathroom attached to the master bedroom is working, and I do find myself getting up about once a night to go to the bathroom, and about once every 3 nights or so, I would say, probably like 2 nights a week, I'm finding myself waking up and not able to go back to sleep. They call it pregnancy insomnia. My app told me that that could happen. I'm not really worried about it, but it is kind of annoying. Like, basically, I'll sleep really well from like 9 p.m. to like 1 a.m., and then I'll be up for an hour or two. One night this last 2 weeks, I woke up in the middle of the night. I just wasn't feeling well. I still had the cold and everything, so I went and took a bath in the middle of the night, and I fell asleep on my office floor, just laying on the floor, because I didn't want to go back to bed with my hair wet. My blow dryer was in the master where my husband was sleeping, and I didn't want to wake him up. And so I just like fell asleep on the floor, and he came in at like 7 something in the morning and was like, do you want to go back to bed? And I was like, oh, hi. And he's like, did you sleep on the floor all night? I'm like, I guess. I mean, I don't know why I didn't go to the couch or whatever, but that's how sleepy I am. It's just like the middle of the night, I just can't sleep well. I do have my whole setup. I got like 6 pillows I sleep with every night now, or at least 4, to get comfortable. So it's kind of pathetic. My part of the couch is just, or my part of the bed is just covered in pillows, but that's how I like it. And it's probably going to stay like that for a while. I do have my pregnancy pillow, but I still prefer making like a custom pillow fort out of several different pillows so that I can move them throughout the night to, you know, please me. And last thing is that we are working on planning my baby shower. So many of you know, a couple weeks ago we had my sister's baby shower, and she's due about 2 months before me. And so her shower is all over with now. And tomorrow, my mother-in-law and my mom and I are going to be discussing my baby shower and like what the theme is going to be and where we're going to have it and who's going to be invited and, you know, that kind of thing. So I'm really excited. I've been doing a lot of Pinteresting and got some things for the nursery. I got a blanket. I got fabric to make a pillow. I've gotten the fabric to make a valance for the nursery. My mom's going to sew that. And I'm still looking for things like the rug and stuff. I do want to do a nursery tour, but her name is going to be on the wall. And so I have to wait to do the nursery tour until I'm ready to reveal the name. I'm thinking it'll be probably early April because the baby shower theme has something to do with kind of like her name. And so I will be doing a baby shower vlog. So you'll see the name, you'll see kind of the theme. So I think I'll just go ahead and tell you guys around April. I'm not due till mid-May though. So that's still a pretty early name reveal, in my opinion. But I have been taking little snippets of the nursery, like when it was completely empty before it was painted, and then after it was painted, and then now that I'm organizing, I've been taking little, little like 1 minute segments to make a vlog, and I'll string them all together, how the nursery came together. So I think that'll be really fun. I've been trying to do one pregnancy video a week. And then, so like every other week, it's the pregnancy updates, like week 25, 26. And then the following week would be something unrelated, like a pregnancy maternity clothes haul or something like that. So my maternity must-haves, things like that. So let me know if you guys have any requests besides the ones that I've mentioned before that I'm gonna do, a nursery tour, name reveal, my baby shower vlog, maybe a haul from all the baby stuff we've gotten, the nursery, like how it's coming together, labor and delivery vlog, what's in my hospital bag, all that stuff. So if you have any other questions, I want to do a Q&A video. So if you have any questions about what I want to do for the baby or whatever, let me know also in the comments. Or let me know if there's any other videos in the series you want to see me do, because we're running out of time. I think today I have 94 days or 95 days until my due date. So pretty exciting. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Comment down below if you are also pregnant. Let me know your symptoms and what you've been going through this last couple of weeks. Thanks for watching. Bye.